Well, ladies and gentlemen, it is that time again. Time to try a project that I haven't done in actually ever since I started any kind of Skyrim series whatsoever on the channel. Something some of you might have probably found the channel through, and others might be, you know, interested to experience again. Nevertheless, welcome everybody, how's it going? My name is Tamriel. This is Skyrim, and today, if you can guess by the ridiculously odd height of my character, we're gonna be starting a kid character. Again, a little orphaned child, you know, living in really rough lands of Skyrim. I felt like the Shiva storyline that I had on Shiva, Shia. Shia storyline came from Shiva from Final Fantasy, but I felt like the Shia storyline was going a little bit too well. Like, we didn't have difficulties there. It was mostly just fun, berserking, and none of that survival aspect that I really enjoyed. These weren't prevalent. So I'm thinking we start with a kid character. Her name is Kara, or Kara, however you want to pronounce it, and I believe we can go with a cool storyline. I actually thought of it just like right before I was putting together the character. Now, the mods I'm running aren't any particular mods, they're just same mods that I've been running with. It just did a lot of content commands and, you know, a lot of puffing up of the face that I had to do in order to make her look like a kid character. She still doesn't look perfect. She still looks a little bit too mature, a little bit too, you know, like in her mid-20s, mid-30s. But this is the best I could do right now. I'll see if I can maybe download some textures for some eyes, make him look bigger, and just make her look very kid-like and everything. So yeah, Skyrim Special Edition still doesn't have a lot of like kid mods, but if you tinker with it a little bit and you play around a little bit, either, you know, on any Skyrim versions, you could probably come up with something creative, maybe. Nevertheless though, I'm gonna have fun doing this and playing as Kara here. So I'm thinking for her storyline, we can make her a child of two merchants, merchants by trade, her mother and father. Since something politically, you know, something politically charged started happening elsewhere, they decided it would be better if, you know, they stayed together rather than leaving the kid alone at home or, you know, with somebody there. So the entire family decided, you know, Mom, Pop, and Kara decided to start traveling together. And Kara, while not really learning much, except, like, you know, some bartering things here and there, and just to kind of, you know, her average ability to use her claws. She doesn't have any weapon skills. She has no, you know, affinity with magic. He's a kid, you know, she's just a kid. Just learning how to survive on her own is going to be difficult for her. But I think for the storyline, we can either go with the Shipwrecked questline or with the Left 4 Dead questline. Because with either one of those, we can make a scenario of, you know, the parents, you know, they got into an accident. Either they, you know, the ship wrecked because of, you know, crazy storm. Or, you know, they got attacked by bandits and she passed out in a forest. And then she wakes up and her parents are nowhere to be found. And she, you know, is on a quest to try to find them, try to figure out where they are. That could be kind of a cool storyline. At the same time, would give us huge, huge, I don't know, just bonuses with just learning how to, you know, survive in the game and everything. And just actually do the whole survival thing. Because Shia's story was a little bit too easy, in my opinion. So, let's talk to Sachio Mara and see what we get.
Approach, my child, and choose where your new life shall begin.
I'm really digging the point of being attacked in Left 4 Dead, and the worst part about it is we do have the DLCs unlocked, so the place could just throw us into, you know, the aisle from the, what is it called again? I completely forget the name, but it's the bonus aisle that comes with the Dragonborn DLC. I can't recall it right now, I don't know why. Morrowind Asheria, that's all I will say for now. But yeah, we could go there, possibly. That's literally, it's a gamble when it comes to this thing. But I still want to take it. I still want to take it.
The light of hope shines even for you. Don't give up.
We will not, Mara. We will not. We will begin our adventure as a little kid trying to survive in this dark, cruel world. Oh my god, I'm actually, I want to save just in case, because I don't know what's going to happen. But let's go ahead and start this, ladies and gents, and pray that we hopefully don't end up somewhere terrible. Let's see what we get. Wow, the intro is extremely fitting to the scenario I was thinking of with the parents, where the parents got attacked by bandits, and then now we're left for dead. Okay, well, there's a There's a wolf over there. We are a tiny little kid after all. We should probably go ahead and stay away from wolves. So yeah, wow, this would be, oh my god, and there was our, and there would be our dad. And we found our dad. Where's our mom? Where'd our mom go? No, this is too real. This is way, no. This is way too real and too set up. Seriously, I did not expect for this to be like a legit storyline. This would be technically the dad in this situation. And there's a horse, you know, our carriage horse that was taking us everywhere. And that's our dad. God, this is too real. Where did mom go? What would the bandits take her? Wow, this gotten extremely real. And the scary part is we are right near the Johnson and Mammothi, whatever. We're right near them. God, this is so set up. All right. Well, okay. I mean, clearly, you know, clearly Kara would be extremely sad to see her dad die, but they all knew what's gonna happen, you know, they all knew what would be, you know, ahead of them at the time. Clearly she cannot take, you know, the armor that he wears because he has, you know, the armor wouldn't fit her, and she wouldn't want to, you know, take anything from her dad, but she will pick up the weapon, and she'll, you know, she'll try to come back for her dad next, you know, in the future to try to come back and maybe, you know, bury away the body, because there's nothing she can do about it right now. She's right now panicking. She doesn't know what to do. She feels like maybe some things that have here that have survived could be, you know, good for her. Maybe books, necklace to sell later, boots, clothes to wear in case it gets really cold. Also, how do I start up the quest line for Frostfall again? Effect, Frostfall from Magic Menu and press Shout. Okay, let's go ahead and activate Frostfall then. What is it? Options, Campfire, Frostfall. There we go. You be able to start Frostfall? Yeah, let's go ahead and start Frostfall. Lost in thought, reflect in the book how much you wish you thought, yep, about this whole survival thing. Let's go ahead and read the book so we can go ahead and get Frostfall set up here. I already read the book several times in the past, but we do have to go through the book, and the game has to recognize that we have gone through the book in order for us to continue with the storyline in general and to actually start the mod. The mod makes sure that, you know, that we actually read the book and we know, you know, we are aware of everything that's going on. I'm already very much aware of it, but for somebody like Kara, this, I'm gonna go with Kara, you know, I'm just gonna stick with Kara. That's how you're supposed to pronounce it. For Kara, this book will be the only means of survival for her. And now, her life begins. Now prepare to face a colder, harsher Skyrim. I'll be alone by ourselves. Okay. It's okay, girl. Kara, just pick up whatever you can. Take whatever things you can here that could be possibly worth of value. What is this to you? The Rehoboth Azarian. God damn it, that was our dad's favorite book. No, dad. Damn it. Why'd it have to happen like this? Clothing and armor. Yep, I understand all about that. Leg of goat, plates, sack of flour. Anything we could take out of here at all. Horse meat, anything at all. That, you know, that we need with us. We're for the best. And now we are as warm as we possibly can be. What else we got here? Another book. We'll take that. The Wolf King Book 4. Is anything else we can take? So the storyline, the game already sets us up this really tragic scenario, this really tragic end of being attacked by bandits and just being raided. Now dad is dead, and our mom is nowhere to be found. Our horse that was taking us is also dead. The only thing we have currently to our name is a couple of septums and a weapon. I'm guessing we're traveling across, you know, across Skyrim somewhere. So now we gotta try to find some way of, I don't know, putting ourselves together. The book that we did find that our dad left us did say that we could make clothing, warm clothing, out of wolves. And there is a wolf over there. And I believe, for some reason, actually, yes, I do believe I do have a mod turned on that makes animals still, you know, less likely to get into combat. I might want to turn it off for this scenario. I think it would be actually really cool if we did turn it off. So here, I'm going to be right back. I'm going to turn that mod off, and then we'll continue back up from here. So I checked just now, and it looks like according to my current layout, I actually don't have that mod installed, so I should be able to approach the wolves over there, actually get into some sort of squabble with them. Well, for not being a fighter, a trained fighter of a sort, I think it's best if you try to take on only one wolf here. Now, I don't know what can happen. I'll take all this, though, gladly. Let me make sure to see if I got everything. Okay, it looks like we got everything. We can take our dad's armor. It's still a little too heavy on us, plus it wouldn't fit us anyway. Maybe we can take the hide boots and bracers. That's the only thing that could fit us, if anything. And it will keep us warm as well. The metal armor would not do anything for us, though. Let's put these on. Okay. See if you can take on a wolf. Looks like just one wolf over there. See if you can approach it nice and easy. God, we're so short. We're the size of the wolf. Okay. And it's running away. Never mind. Looks like for some reason still critters are less likely to attack. Okay, well that's gonna be called a dilemma whenever we try to hunt things down. Alright. At least he ran away. Probably like a pup or something. Maybe it was actually. I do have a couple of animal mods installed. Alright. Well, the first thing we need to do is see if he can maybe collect the stuff. I don't know. Somebody may want to buy it. We need to find food. That's what we need. We have like only limited rations. We need to find food or find some sort of settlement where we can like report this to guard or something. Let him know what's going on. There are a couple wolves over there. Should try to fight a wolf, shouldn't I? It's another cub. I'm gonna try to strike it. Oh, god damn it, son of a bitch, come here. Oh, shit. Okay, so it looks like wolves don't attack unless you actually attack them. I don't know if it was part of the mod or not, but it is what it is. Okay. Jesus. From our height, this is gonna be terrible. This is gonna be terrifying. Poor child. Poor Kara. She's getting scarred by all this. Alright. We just see if we can do this here. Campfire, frostfall, wet and cold. No, that's not what we need here. Instincts, inspector equipment, sets of control. We need let's see, campfire. Wet and cold. I believe we should use options campfire to be able to craft something, shouldn't we? Camping, tents, instincts. No, it's just settings, never mind. That's not what we need. We need some sort of way to craft. I believe there was a ability we used to have to actually craft things. I guess it's kind of gone now. We do have instincts, so we can focus on instincts as a survivalist and see what's going on around us. Kind of puts us in survival instinct form. There is a wolf here that we have killed already. We can't get anything from them. No flowers around here. Alright. See if we could just, I don't know, advance forward and try to find nearest town with the guards. Otherwise, we're gonna be dead. Honestly, we could probably be dead out here. There's somebody over there. Mammoths are passing by. It's best we let the mammoths cross without them noticing us. Oh, we're gonna get in trouble here, Lingents. We're gonna get in trouble. The mammoths freak out, then giants may also freak out. I don't want either of that to happen. So we're gonna try to be as careful as we can. Avoid the mammoths. There we go. Let the mammoths do the thing. We also gotta watch out for ourselves here. I don't know what's out here. That's the worst part. We don't know what's out here. Looks like the giant might be seeing us now. Gotta just stay low, stay meek, stay meager. Should be able to avoid all of them. Jesus, I completely forgot what it's like to see the world of Skyrim from, you know, from the kid's eyes. And the wolves around. Oh shit! You gotta be kidding me. Well, that's gonna be a problem. Hi, Maik.
Maik wishes you well. Keep your hands to yourself.
Okay. Never mind. He does not want to deal with no kid. Okay, crazy Maik. Go, crazy Maik is a crazy Maik. I need to try to kill some of these wolves here. Come here. No, come here. Oh, Jesus. Okay. I don't know why we're more likely to actually kill him like this, but we do need the pelts. I believe we should have a power to... Yeah, we should be able to have a power to craft at a certain point, I believe. Resourcefulness? There we go, resourcefulness. Campfire, harvest wood, create item. Can we create anything out of the hide? We should be able to create at least like a cloak or something. Linen wraps? We can make linen wraps, if anything. Or out of books, I guess. A fur plate, fur plates. What do we need to make in order to make, you know, warm clothing here? 3 hide lace and 3 fur plate. Do we have hide lace? I don't know if we actually do. We can make linen wraps. Miner's clothes. I guess I can make some linen wraps out of clothes if I can replace something with what I have. Oh. Okay, I don't see anything. I thought I heard mammoths, you know, walking behind me. That's why I kind of freaked out there. Alright, let's try to use this ability again. So we need to have some. What if we make some fur plates? What about linen wraps? We need a fur plate for linen wraps. We got horse hide. We can go ahead and trade that in. Make some hide lace. Okay, now we should be able to make some things to keep us nice and warm. Making fur armor would be probably best. If we can only make another fur plate. Let's make another fur plate and see if we can make a full armor here. That's going to keep us a lot warmer than this partial armor. Does it matter between these three? Doesn't seem like it, so I'm going to go ahead and make this then. Okay, can we make another fur plate? Need more hide lace though. Okay, well that's all we got for now. Let's go and put on the apparel. Fur armor. Using the skills that were found in the book. That's the only reason we can actually make this stuff. Otherwise, we would not be able to, you know, make this stuff whatsoever. So technically, I am, you know, following the lore, I guess. Follow my own rules. Let's rip apart Miner's clothes in order to see if he can make something a little bit later. I think we can make something out of wood. No, not out of wood. Should be able to make something here later. If we collect 15 snowberries, we could make the extract. We need firewood as well. Finding a torch of some sort would be for the best for us. We'll make some sort of our bedding out of fur plate. If we can hunt down another wolf, that'd probably be for the best. Or anything at all. An elk. Or anything whatsoever. Need to make them aggressive again, honestly. I need to see if I can make the animals aggressive again so that they'll actually run to me and I don't have to run to them. Alright. Stay calm, Kyra. Just stay calm. Be fine. As long as I know. Oh. Is that a wolf? That is a wolf. There could also be saber cats here. That's the worst part about this place, is that this place is dangerous. This is like one of the probably worst place to be in. There's a fox over there. Should get the fox. Let's get the fox. It's either the fox or us. It's either the fox or us. Come here. Come on. Son of a bitch. Quit running. Quit running. Quit running. Quit running. Okay. This is gonna be... This is probably the most difficult thing that the girl has ever had to do. Ever. Okay. Can we make the rough bedding? Okay. Made the bedding. We should be able to... Also, we should make a linen or burlap. Let's make a linen cloth right now. There we go. That'll keep us nice and warm and protected throughout, you know, everything that we're dealing with. Jesus Christ. Poor kid. Poor kid has to deal with this. That's... Oh, wow. That's actually a nice looking cloak. That'll keep us nice and warm in case something happens. Oh, shit. No.
I've been looking for you. Got something I'm supposed to deliver. Your hands only.
Huh?
Let's see. Looks like that's it. Got to go.
Oh, yeah, the courier always comes up. Never mind. Everybody please ignore the courier. Kyra just lost her family. She doesn't need no courier in her life. Alright, well, let's try to see if we can make our way down here, though. Finding a decent shelter, like an abandoned house, would probably be best in case it gets, like, dark and cold. And we could make... Since we made our own bedding, we should be able to survive the nights or something. There's a house over there. I want to investigate that. Let's go this way and see if we can check out this house looking area. Oh. Wait, is that a farm? Oh, it is a farm, isn't it? Oh, finally, people. And hopefully guards. Kinds group discovered. Okay, well, that's good. That's good. At least we got some sort of, you know, some sort of a settlement. Finding some sort of guards to, you know, talk to and... What is this called? Braidwood Inn, right? Yeah, Braidwood Inn. Nice. Okay, well, that's good. We talk to the guard.
Stay out of trouble, Khajiit.
Oh. Looks like guards might not actually be able to help us here whatsoever. Oh. Can you not help a little Khajiit girl out?
Everything all right?
No, I lost my parents that got attacked.
Trouble?
Yeah, that's a lot of trouble.
The Imperials think us all lawless beasts. I'm proof of their ignorance.
Yeah, could you help me find my mom? My dad got killed.
They say Ulfric Stormcloak murdered the High King with his voice. Shouted him apart.
It's gonna be difficult to try to get some help out here. It's gonna be really, really difficult. Okay, I'm gonna see if I can talk to the guards a little bit more. Maybe we can get, you know, realize what's happening here locally. And that's it. I'll see you in a little bit.
Is there something I can do for you?
I don't think a lot of people can really do anything for Kyra. Some time has passed. She tried to convince the guards to go check out the place and see if they can investigate, try to find her parents.
Another wanderer, slumming it on your way to Windhelm.
I've never seen you before. Leave me alone.
And people are really not friendly against this poor Khajiit girl. Although she does look very mature. Like, I try to make her look as babyface as possible, and I'll see if I can try to toy with it a little bit more. Some people have been really nice and polite and say, have a feel for her and said that she can go out to the mine and mine some ore, and then she can sell, you know, they'll purchase it from her, you know, to give her some cash and give her, you know, a reason to stay in this inn if she even wants to pay the price to stay here. Or she'll probably just camp out outside. They said that you can go camp out with the other people out there. There are some people out there currently using like the front lawn of a house to camp, so she could camp there with a little bedroll and all.
What can I do for you?
But other than that, what you can do for me is try to help my parents. Nobody seems to want to help her. So yeah, that's the main issue. They did send the guards out there to investigate, but they came back with nothing. No clues or nothing, and they decided to go up on a search because it's some Khajiit out there. They don't really care much about it, so the poor girl, if I could give her, you know, a tear that you could shed, I gladly would. But it's a little bit impossible because of lack of mods and too much editing, ridiculous amount of editing that I had to do. But she's in a very, very sad predicament, sad situation right now. A lot of people think of her as a squanderer. The innkeeper said she is allowed to stay only if she has the coin. Otherwise, she has to, you know, sleep outside with everybody else or with other people that don't want to pay. And this lady in particular really doesn't like Kara. Really, really doesn't like her. She doesn't like Khajiit in general. Anyway, let's try to first get some food on her. Make sure she's nice and full. We might have to buy, for 12 gold, we might have to buy some things. What do we have here that we could possibly sell? We have the gold necklace and the silver garnet ring. Garnet ring? I think it's garnet ring. That we could sell. They aren't anything in particular. I mean, this is the ring that, you know, the dad had from the marriage. And sadly, we might have to sell that. This is the necklace of our mother. Might have to sell it as well. It doesn't have any particular resemblance. It's just a necklace she decided to wear just because. So we may have to sell some of these things in order to make the money, in order to stay the night here. We should probably try to talk to the innkeeper and see if they would want to purchase that from her.
Grove? That? Well, that was me. Me and my sister.
Maybe talking to some of the locals might be good for her in the long run. Maybe see if they can, you know, offer some sort of hospitality. Oh, you ain't gonna offer no hospitality, lady. I don't like you.
Did you see my husband already? I'm sorry. He can come off a bit rough at times.
Welcome to Kynes Grove. If you want to do business here, you'll have to deal with me.
I hope you'll stay for a bit. We could certainly use the business.
If I can even afford it.
If it's malachite you're after, you've come to the right place. I'll pay for any you dig up out of Steam Scorch Mine.
There we go. Then we got some sort of a job that she could do, possibly, while she, you know, saves up more money to travel to other places or just to try to, I don't know, go to somewhere in the capital to try to talk about her mother. That's could be the, you know, the key aspect here. The Stormcloaks don't really seem to care much, so the only other place she could ever go to is Solitude in order to, you know, talk to the guard and try to have somebody find her mother. Or even go to maybe Riverwood. This is technically, I guess, Windhelm area. But still, we should try to, you know, go from capital city or like major city to major city and talk to the bigger powers to try to find her mother.
Aye.
Poor Rogie. If you're feeling charitable, buy the Nord a mead. He's good for it.
Who's Rogie?
He's been in Kynes Grove forever. Great storyteller. Keeps everyone's spirits up. Owes me a lot of coin for drinks. I keep telling him not to worry about it, but he's got the stubborn Nord blood. Damn fool doesn't have the coin to pay me back, so he just beats himself up over it, and then he gets thirsty, and it cycles all over again.
What if I talk to Rogi?
If you could convince him that I don't care about his tab, it'd certainly make me feel better.
Alright, is there anything you would like to maybe buy from me, like the necklace and stuff?
Take a look.
Alright, well, let's see if... No, she'll only buy food from us. Well, we do have horse meat that we don't particularly need. And leg of goat roast. I guess we can still keep this. It's still technically food. This is raw, so we should not be eating that. We can sell that. Sack of flour, we should probably... Well, it's not going to cost us anything, so we should probably just go ahead and keep it with us. Alright. Let's see if we can maybe spend the night here for 10 gold. This is going to be a gamble. Maybe we should save. You know, it'd probably be best if we do save our gold for the night.
All right then.
We should see
is
if maybe.
Something I can do for you?
No, there isn't. You're actually a really mean lady, so we're gonna go ahead and avoid you for now. She's a mean old lady, and she's all cranky and stuff. We're gonna go ahead and try to avoid her. It is evening time in Skyrim for now, so before anything does. Nope.
Kjeld speaks for Kynesgrove. Anyone who says otherwise is aching for a fight.
Okay. Who was it that ran off here? I just saw somebody run away. Or run off to a side. Where did they go? Wait, is that you? Nope, that's not you. It's like a lady that ran off here. Oh! Well, there she is, okay. Not sure why she ran off here. It's currently evening time. Cold weather. The area is cold and your exposure will begin to increase. Yep. It's getting cold, alright, and that's for sure. That's an understatement, to be honest. Hi, how's it going?
Huh?
Oh, she's a higher bodyguard. Fire and
is
shelter, yep, I know about that.
Something I can do for you?
Vanilla? Hi, Jesus yes. Christ, she's tall. Wow, she is. Lady, you're really, really tall, aren't you? Compared to her, you're damn tall.
Rogi and I do the work around here. My wife and brats just sit around on their brains, wasting time.
Damn. Okay, then. Yeah, clearly doesn't like his family or something. Hello there.
You don't look so tough. I'll bet I could take you.
Why are you abusing a little kid? I'm just a little Khajiit kid. Why are you? Well, at least I got some comfortable bedrolls I guess we can use while we stay over here. We are feeling a bit hungry. Can we use any of the food that we got? Now we're feeling well sated. Okay, that's good. And I mean, this is a farm of a sort, so I hope nobody will care if we pick up some leeks here and there. I don't know, they will. But yeah, this is a story of Kara. She doesn't really have a lot for her right now, but she can camp outside. It's not going to be the most comfortable life ever, but she does have a job that she can still undertake nevertheless over at the mine. Maybe she can go there during the day or something and maybe, I don't know, mine something up. I think that'd be pretty cool. You know, some sort of way for her to, you know, scrounge up some money. And these people are being extremely nice as well. They, you know, they're offering her hospitality and even offering to pay for her hard labor as she, you know, lives in this very, very tiny remote little town. We can go up north if we really want to, over to Windhelm, as far as she learned, or we can head over south to Riften. I believe the family was traveling from Windhelm over to Riften, and since they were killed in this area, which I guess was called like the No Man's Land, they might be lost because a lot of bandits and giants do hang out here, and as well as other really, really difficult creatures. So not a lot of people will want to go out here to go search for them. There are people of Kynesgrove that do live here, but live here for, you know, the specific, you know, reasons, some of them being religious, I guess, or spiritual. If let's say the parents were, you know, lost somewhere over in the Riften area, like the Riften jurisdiction, I guess, so to speak, then that's something the guards could do for it. But a best bet at the moment, probably not to go to Windhelm. They'll probably not care. I mean, they're just full of Stormcloaks, and Stormcloaks don't like Khajiit, so there'll be no reason for us to even ask them anything. If anything, the highest power we can try to find is in Solitude, which, you know, so far it's, you know, trying to rule over Skyrim. There's a whole, you know, civil war thing happening, and while we're not really, you know, directly involved in it, we do need to talk to some sort of bigger power out there that could try to find our mother, since our father, you know, is already dead. We can't do anything regarding the father. And what is this here thing over here? Oh, for Sophia. Let me go ahead and actually take it off here real quick. There we go. I'll keep miscellaneous on. We can talk to Rogi about Ibra. I guess we could do that. No problem. But yeah, this is currently the adventure we got going on for poor little Kara. That's going to be something difficult for her to, you know, deal with as she goes on and tries to live through this place. But this is the best she can do. Honestly, if this series goes well, we'll probably continue with this. If not, we can always come back to Shea and, you know, Eric. They're great adventures. Just with Shea and Eric, it felt like they were doing a little bit too well. Too well for my taste, for my comforts. You know, I need the challenge. I need the difficulty part of it. I need the survival. The sad moments, the sad story of a poor little Khajiit kid being, you know, separated from parents. So one parent dies, apparently. Good lord. That start was just so well done. But nevertheless, then, Gem, I'm going to go ahead and actually wrap up right here, and I'll continue on in next episode in the future. Thank you so much for watching. I really hope you enjoyed. Let me know what you think about this. Like, subscribe, and as always, have a great day, and I'll see you on next episode of Skyrim. Please leave all the feedback in the comments below. I'd love to see if y'all would like to see the story be continuing in the future. Anyway, see ya.